Hi, I'm Darren Hartwell here in the NESN Studios with your Fantasy Baseball Minute. Our focus today is on first baseman, which is one of the deepest positions in fantasy baseball. There are a ton of first basemen out there who can give you plenty of power and hit for average, but the key is finding players who can do both of those on a consistent basis. With that said, let's take a look at some green light guys who I would have no hesitation taking in the beginning of your draft. Starting in the American League, the first guy I'm giving the green light to is Chicago White Sox first baseman Jose Abreu. In recent years, the must-own fantasy guy at first base always has been Miguel Cabrera. But Cabrera had some injuries last year, and honestly, after Abreu's rookie season, I think he might have the potential to put up better numbers. Abreu hit 36 homers and 170 RBIs while still posting a .317 batting average. It's hard to find that kind of power and that kind of average out of a first baseman. So I think Abreu could be destined to do big things and even surpass some of the eye-popping numbers that Cabrera has put up in recent years. Turning to the National League now, my green light guy is Arizona Diamondbacks first baseman Paul Goldschmidt. Goldschmidt is another guy who can really do it all for you. He hits for average, he hits for power, one of the best power hitters in the National League, and he even steals bases on top of it. This is a guy who finished second in the MVP race in 2013. He had his season cut short in 2014, missed the last 2 months of the season with a hand injury. I'd expect a big bounce back year in 2015 and more of those same power numbers. So Abreu and Goldschmidt, those guys are good to go, given the green light. These next few guys, not so much. A guy I'd give the red light to in the American League is Oakland A's first baseman Billy Butler. Butler has shown signs of having a more consistent approach at the plate, but none of his numbers will really blow you away. His power numbers dipped from 15 homers in 2013 to just 9 in 2014, and his batting average fell off from .289 to .271. He's also making the transition from Kansas City to Oakland, and he might have some trouble transitioning to the new ballpark. And last but not least, or maybe in this case least, I'm giving the red light to Miami Marlins first baseman Michael Morse. Morse won a World Series ring with the San Francisco Giants last season, but he only hit 16 homers and 61 RBIs, which is a far cry from the 31 homers and 95 RBI he hit in 2011. Morse does have Giancarlo Stanton in his lineup, and batting behind a guy like that could add to his value. I think there are other names out there who could give you better value than Morse.